Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we'll be painting another flower, and this is of course my favorite flower of all time, another iris flower. But well, this is the first time that I'll be painting an iris this color, because iris has a lot of it has a wide range of colors. And this one, I kind of liked it because I really don't have this color of flower. So let me tell you the color. It's blue. Blue iris. Yay! So this is quite interesting. And as you already know, or most of you already know, I love the iris flower. Since my trip to France, I've been in love with this flower. I guess I will love this flower forever. Okay, guys, let me tell you the colors that we'll be using for today's painting. Okay, we have tons of phthalo blue, we have cobalt blue, permanent light green, permanent yellow light, black, tiny bit of violet. I don't know if you can see that, but that tiny bit of violet, and of course titanium white. That's it. So let's begin now. The background of the painting will be black, and the background is quite, it's not consuming a lot of space, so we'll do it last, okay? So let's begin now, guys. I'm gonna underpaint first the petals. Okay. Wash your brush out. And I'm gonna get my cobalt blue mixed with phthalo. Like this. Like this color. And then I'm gonna add some violet to it. Violet, like this color. Okay. So yeah, I'm gonna underpaint it now. Okay. For this painting, I'm using canvas paper. Recently, I've been using canvas cloth, but this time it's canvas paper, guys. Okay, like this. So just underpaint. And don't worry yet. Don't worry. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna water down. I'm gonna water down the paint that's on my brush and start painting the upper portion of the flower as if you're using watercolor, like that. So again, I'm using a lot of water. Actually, more water, guys. So this is very watercolor technique. We're not using watercolor, we're using acrylics, but for this flower I kind of like the watercolor effect. Okay, and then you can use your fingers just to spread it quite evenly on your canvas. All right, like that. I'm gonna extend it here. Like that. I'm using a lot of water and I kind of like it because when it dries it's gonna look pretty. Okay, like that. And then up here, also, water down. like this. Like that. And then we're gonna get the main color, the not watered down kind of color. And then continue. I'm just gonna damp it. Okay, like that. Okay, same color. And as you already know, when we're doing the underpainting, we're gonna paint over it, definitely. Okay. So again, this is just a combination of phthalo blue, cobalt blue, and violet. Don't stress yourself so much about the colors. Because again, this is just the underpainting. All right, then I'm gonna water down my blue. Here, like that. And spread it, like using my fingers, like that. All right, like that. I'm gonna use the same watered down blue here. Use your fingers to spread it here. Okay, like that. We're just identifying where the blue colors are. This is not the actual color. We're not yet done. Okay, here. Some blues. Okay, I'm gonna water it down again. Like that. And create some soft brush strokes. They're not even brush strokes, they're just dabs of paints. Okay, like that. And then I'm gonna use my fingers just to blend quite. I'm gonna mix my phthalo with black. All right. I'm gonna make some line here. Okay, I'm gonna make some line there. As well. All right, I'm gonna water down my black color like that. Okay, like that. Okay. All right. Now that I have my black on my paintbrush, okay, I'm gonna paint now the background because, yeah, we don't want to waste our paints. Here as well. Mm-hmm. Okay, like that. Just use black, guys. Just use black. Okay, spin that. Okay, I'm gonna use my black again. We're gonna switch to a more pointy brush later. Okay, like that. Get your black. We're not yet done with the background. Well, the advantage of this as well is the paints start to dry now, so the highlighting will be easier later. Okay. Actually, I need to change the brush. It's getting narrower and narrower. Okay, I'm gonna change my brush. More pointy brush. Like that. Okay, so now you can see the shape of it. Okay, now let's go back here because we can now go into smaller areas. Just black. Okay, like that. Okay. Okay, just a few more. Just a few more, guys. So we finally got the shape of the iris flower. All right. I'm gonna use this black mixture and mix it with cobalt blue, like this, and violet and phthalo. As long as you get the dark blue mixture. Okay, get the dark blue mixture, like this. And we're gonna start making some dark areas here. Maybe add some black. It's not that dark for me. Okay, like that. Yeah. It's really a good thing that we waited for the paint to completely dry before we did this. I can tell that, well, my application is quite better wet on dry than wet on wet. I'm just not a fan of wet on wet, guys. Not really. Okay, like that. All right. Okay, and then here as well. Just darken some areas, dark blues. All right, here as well. Here as well. Okay, you can wash your brush out. Okay, I'm gonna do this part already. I'm gonna get my green mixed with tiny bit of black and maybe tiny bit of yellow as well. So it's like this color, so mixture of yellow, green, and black. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna use this green mixture to somehow apply it here. Quite watery though. And here as well. Like that. Water it down, guys, when you apply this color. Wash your brush out. then again, get some blue and then mix it with white. Okay, paler blue, cobalt blue, and then water it down and just apply it here. Okay, like that. I'm gonna combine this with a lot of white. Okay, like this color. Okay, more white, guys. Like that. Okay, more white. Okay, like that. And here as well. More white. Here as well. You can even do that. Do it this way, like that, so that you give some natural shape to the petal, like that. And I'm very random in applying the color. I don't want any structure on the flower. Yeah, that makes sense. As long as you don't deviate from the general shape of the flower, it's okay. All right, like that. Okay, I'm gonna get white. I'm just gonna apply it like that. And then I'm gonna use my fingers just to blend so that we don't get that hard line. Okay, like that. Okay, so I'm just using white and light blue. Also here. Like that. Okay, same color down here. Like that. And I'm gonna make it like quite dark by adding blue. Gonna add white to it. Okay, again, light blue, guys. Here. And we're gonna do a lot of detailing later. For now, let's just color block everything. Okay, like that. All right. Washa washa. Okay, I'm gonna get more of my violet because I ran out. Okay, so I'm gonna get my violet and then cobalt blue, like that. Tiny bit of white. And we're gonna color it here. Just color. Like that. Okay, same color, violet and cobalt blue. Okay. Just gonna add some more detailing. Okay, I think I have to add some black to it so that it becomes a little dark. Like that. Okay. Now we can do some veins. Okay, it's quite thick. Okay, anyway, let's go back to it later. I'm just gonna add more detailing. Okay, like that. I'm gonna get more violet. I'm gonna water down. Like that. Okay. I'm gonna use the same mixture. It's quite thick. All right, like that. And then I'm gonna use this mixture, watered down, just to darken the bottom petal. Just glaze, guys. Glaze. Okay, like that. Okay, also I'm gonna use this color to outline the petals, to separate the petals from each other. We don't want them to be like, you know, flat and all that. Try to separate, guys. Okay, like that. Here as well. Okay, and here and here. So we're just separating the petals by outlining each of them. All right. Okay, I'm gonna use this same mixture. And then create something like this. Detailing on the petal. Okay, like that. I'm sorry. All right. Here. Okay, I'm gonna use this color, okay, to get some white. Okay, get some white, guys. Okay, more violet, perhaps. Okay, more violet this time. Make some highlights here. Right, and then here, okay, I'm gonna add white to it. Like that. Right, like that. So I'm just making some highlights. Using white. Watered down, of course. Okay. It's like white violet, light violet. Like that. I'm gonna use the same violet mixture here. Then make some highlights on the petals like this. So your strokes should be like that, you know, always in one direction. One direction. Like the boy band. Okay, here as well, like that. Okay, push up, push up. I'm gonna use my dark blue just to make some shadows and some details like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my black. And we're going to define our petals. Use my black just for shading. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna mix my black with my blue and make some dark areas here. Okay, wash your brush out. Okay, I'm gonna get my burnt sienna. Okay, so that, you know, we'll wait for the paint to dry. I'm gonna get my yellow. Okay, burnt sienna plus black. Tiny bit of black. Like that. Mm-hmm. Okay, like that. All right, like that. I'm gonna water down my burnt sienna plus yellow and then apply it here. Like watercolor. Okay. I think we can do the detailing now. Also here. Then we can create some brownie colors like that. Also here, some brownie colors. Okay, wash up a shop. And get your dark blues and just finish this because I wasn't able to close this. Like that. Okay, just that. Okay, I'm gonna use this color to make some more detailing. Thank you.
just darken it. Define the petal again. Okay, so I'm gonna use this color, and mix it with white, like this. Add maybe violet, okay, like this color. As long as it's lighter. And we can go do the highlights now by following the shape of the petals. Okay, just follow it. Like that. And here as well. Also here, make some highlights, guys. And here. And of course here. Like that. Okay, now get lighter white, because we're going to highlight the top petals. Alright, and then we're going to make some more detailing. Okay, more white. Okay, more white. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna get some violet here. Sorry. I think that's too much though, but it's okay. Okay, I'm gonna get my cobalt blue. That's too much. I guess that's too much. Wait. I'm gonna get my white. It's too much. Okay. Yeah, like that. This is the exact color that I like. Yes, like that. So just keep on darkening some areas. So I'm just darkening some areas that need to be darkened. All right, push it, push out. I'm gonna get my black and just glaze it here. Okay, pure black, so that we close this one. Wish you push out. I'm gonna get my white. To create more highlights on the flower. Okay, I'm watering it down. Here, white. And here, more white. Okay, I'm gonna add a tiny bit of yellow to it. That's too. Okay, I'm gonna add a tiny bit of green. It's quite yellow. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my green and white. Green and white, guys. And we're gonna highlight the stem. Okay, you can wash your brush out. So I'm gonna get my cobalt blue plus white. I'm gonna use the same mixture here. Okay, like that. All right, so we're gonna fix this petal at the back. I'm gonna get my violet plus white. Violet, guys. And then I'm just gonna make some highlighted petal here. Okay, like that. I'm gonna add white to it. Okay, same mixture here. Okay, like that. Here as well. I'm just watering it down and applying it so that it becomes more natural looking. Okay, I'm gonna get my black now and I'm gonna make some separation here. They're not absolutely like beside each other. There's a gap, you know. Okay, like that. And then, yeah, just separate the petal like that. Also here, down here. Also, we're gonna separate it here. Wash your brush out. Okay, I'm gonna get my white now. Okay, white guys, pure white. And then I'm gonna water down my white. Water down. All right, like that. Okay, again, water down. I'm gonna use my cobalt blue. There you go again, the noisy thing. Every single time. By the way, guys, you know, I really appreciate it when the viewers actually do my tutorials. I really, really appreciate it. Like, it's a way of showing the most sincere support and interest in art. Yeah, it's the most sincere way of support and interest in art. Of course not, maybe not all are painters, but I'm just, you know, I feel happy when someone creates a painting based on my tutorial. I feel how effective the tutorial is. That, if that makes sense. Get my phthalo blue. Excuse the noise, guys. Okay, let's just give it a moment. Finally. Okay. Okay. Like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my white, guys, white. Okay, I'm just dry brushing and at the same time glazing it. On some areas, like that. Here, dry brushing almost. And here as well. Okay, like that. Alright. Okay, wash your brush out. I'm gonna glaze, guys. So I'm gonna use my violet. Okay. I'm gonna use my violet plus phthalo blue. Alright, like that. And I'm just gonna quickly glaze it so that we don't separate the petals too much. Like this. I'm just using my hand. Okay, like that. Alright. I'm gonna use the same technique here. Can I just move my right like that? I'm just gonna go across like that. So that we create a more natural look, you know? Yeah, I like it. Okay, I'm gonna extend the glazing here, down here. Okay, also here, just to not separate the flowers or the petals from each other, meaning to make the viewer see it as a whole thing. Like that. All right. Okay, I'm gonna get my violet this time. Okay, I'm just gonna glaze it more. Okay. All right. So we're gonna go back to the detailing now. So. Okay, for the detailing, we're actually highlighting. So get your white. White, even if it's mixed with other colors, it doesn't matter. Get your white. Okay, it's noise time again. You know, our building, my unit is well, the building that my unit is situated, or sorry, the street that our building is situated is one of the main streets in Manila. That's why the road is quite busy. And it's one of the most important streets in Metro Manila. That's why. Okay, I'm gonna get pure white this time. Pure white, guys. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna water down my white and apply it here. So I'm gonna get my light violet this time. Okay. Here. Okay. need to water it down. Enjoy the sound, guys. It's okay. Sometimes it tests my patience. Sometimes, and I think I've improved patience-wise. There's nothing wrong with that. In fact, they're just doing their job. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to this and make some more highlights. Oh, no, not highlights, but more like detailing. It's so sunny, guys. If only you can see how bright the sunshine is. So sunny. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my black. Like that. Oh, sorry, I'm gonna get my black again because I have to fix some areas down here. Okay, I'm gonna glaze it with black. To make it quite dark and more natural as well. Okay. Okay, now wash it, push out. Okay, more detailing, guys. More detailing, because all right, we're not gonna stop until I'm happy about it. Gonna get more violet. Okay, more violet plus phthalo blue. Okay, again, just try to make some natural look on the flower. Yeah, like this. I love flowers, guys. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna wet it quite. I'm gonna wet it and then I just keep on reapplying until I'm happy. some little veins like that. Here, yeah, like that. Okay, maybe a little dark color here. To make it more like natural looking. Okay, like this. I'm gonna get my violet. I'm gonna get my white this time. White guys. I'm gonna make some highlights. Like that. I'm so hungry right now. Okay, I'm gonna get my white and I'm trying to like glaze this top portion of the flower. And also to connect the petals, you know, as one. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my pure white again. Here goes the okay, we're almost done, guys. I'm gonna get my burnt sienna, mixed with tiny bit of yellow, tiny bit of black, perhaps, and burnt sienna here. Okay, water. Just create some natural patterns. I'm gonna get my burnt sienna mixed with black. Okay, wash your brush out. Wash it very well. Then get some white, guys. Get some white. And then make some more highlights. I'm gonna mix it with tiny bit of yellow, guys. Tiny bit of yellow. Tiny bit of green as well. Gonna mute it. It's not. All right, I'm gonna water down. As you can tell, I've already, like, almost everything was watered down, but that's how I do detailing of flowers. If you saw some of my previous tutorials of flowers and leaves, I have a playlist. Yeah, you can tell that I love watering down my paints when I paint them, because it helps me achieve that that look. Okay, you know, again, just watering it down. If you're watching, you can see me dipping my brush every single time. I don't have to tell it to you every single time, right? So I'm just adding blue now to the yellow mixture. Okay, like that. Okay, wash your brush out. I'm gonna get more blue this time. Just define. Some white to it. It's too much. You know, the problem with canvas paper is just it's so hard to control the paints. Okay, this looks nice. Okay, I'm just gonna make some white highlights. Of course, it's watered down, guys. Okay, I'm gonna get my violet. Violet. violet and white here. It's so sunny. Oh, sorry. Sorry, guys. So I'm just getting my light blues, blue and white. Again, phthalo and violet here, just to close this. Okay. Wow, this looks nice. Okay, some blues here. I'm gonna get my white now. What's that? Okay, I'm gonna get my white. Okay, pure white, guys. Okay, like that. All right. Okay, just a few more touches, guys. We're almost done now. We're almost done, but I'm gonna get some more of my blues and some blues, guys. Blues. And I'm just gonna dab like that. Okay, like that. Just trying to make the connection. Okay, like that. What else? Okay, I'm gonna get my light blue. Light blue. Okay, more white. I'm just gonna extend it with some highlights. More bright. Some more detailing, guys. We're almost done. I'm just, again, obsessing over details. This is just white. I'm just using it for some veins. Okay, don't worry too much. This is just white paint, and I'm just using the tip of my brush just to apply it. Okay, like that. Be gentle with your brush strokes, though.
I like it a lot.
Okay, I'm just gonna get my light green this time. I think I have to mix it with white like that. Oh, that's too much. Light green, yeah, like that. Just gonna highlight some areas here. Alright, gonna get some white and then some brown and yellow. Okay, like Just one last. Oh, sorry. Let's dry the acrylics. Let me fix that one. All right. Gonna get my black and just. Okay. Then I'm gonna get some brownie color. Brownie color. Okay. Yes. Yes, I'm gonna sign it now, guys. I'm gonna sign it now. I'm gonna get my, I don't know, what color. We have here some green and yellow, so I'm just gonna use it here. Okay, maybe here. Okay, we're done. We're done, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one. And of course, this forms part of my flower painting tutorials. So, of course, after signing it, I have to go back as usual. Like that. Sorry, guys. Just gonna get my yellow. It's not the color yellow that I want. Okay, guys, we're done. We're done! Finally! So I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you do this one as well. And when you do this, please tag me. Again, that just shows that you're watching and enjoying really my tutorials. So thanks, guys. Thanks for all your support and love. And of course, guys.